Hey there.
Welcome to life, Noggin.
Excuse me. Between your ears, you have an amazing piece of hardware. The human brain is the most complex structure ever found, at least according to human brains. There are over 100 billion neurons stuffed in there with trillions of crisscrossing connections. Even our best efforts to recreate it electronically can only mimic small aspects of what the brain can do, like playing a game of Go or saying crazy stuff on Twitter. You want to try to tell me that AI isn't going to try to kill us? Okay. But there is a price for all that complexity. It means that there are a lot of ways for things to go wrong, like hallucinations. Ideally, your brain is taking information from your sensory organs, your eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin, to create a complete picture. But sometimes your brain skips all that and starts playing tricks on you. Ever thought you heard your name when you were all alone, Bobby? I'm just kidding, that wasn't a hallucination, but it was an example of one. Sorry if your name is Bobby and I scared you. Hearing voices is actually the most common hallucination. This is especially true for people with schizophrenia, which is thought to be partially caused by chemical imbalances in the thalamus. That's the part of your brain used to coordinate different sections to work together. To a schizophrenic, these voices sound as real as if someone was in the room talking to them, and they usually comment on what the person is doing or thinking. Oftentimes, they're mean and negative. It's not very pleasant. Brain malfunctions can also cause you to see things that aren't there, like faces with huge teeth and eyes, if a certain part of the fusiform gyrus is overactive. Epilepsy, tumors, or migraines can cause Alice in Wonderland syndrome, where people see the world around them as tiny or gigantic. Migraines can also cause similar hallucinations, like floating jagged patterns. Things are getting a little weird here. Sometimes hallucinations are caused when your senses aren't working properly. People who have gone blind may experience Charles Bonnet syndrome and see whole scenes play out in front of them, though they don't feel like they're a part of it. Instead, it's like watching a boring movie. Elderly people who are hard of hearing sometimes hear music so clearly they're sure it's those darn neighbors with their pop music and stereos. Did I just turn into an old man for a second? You can still have hallucinations even with a healthy brain and working senses. They can happen when you're not feeling your best from lack of sleep, hunger, or fever. Grieving people often still see, hear, and feel the presence of their lost loved ones. And of course, some people choose to alter their brain chemistry intentionally with drugs that can cause hallucinations. Certain drugs like LSD are currently being tested for positive effects on certain conditions. Have you ever had a hallucination? What was it like for you? You can tell us all about it in the comment section below, or tell us what we should talk about next. For some people, their brains can cause them to hear voices, but for others, it turns voices into meaningless gobbledygook. For insight on how your brain makes it possible to understand languages, check out this video.
Model of language, so there is bound to be a few flaws. Recent studies using imaging techniques have shown that the regions around these two areas are also active during language processing. And even more, the right frontal lobe may be involved in comprehending the semantics or meaning of sentences.
There's a link in the description if you're using mobile. As always, I'm Blacko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.